Oh, hey everyone. It's great to see you. I just came in between meetings on the off chance that I could catch in Bali. There are some really exciting things happening this World Environment Day that I wanted to chat to her about. It has to do with the Berg Estuary up the Veskus. Sorry, what was that? Oh, what is the World Environment Day? Well, it's only the biggest international day for the environment led by the United Nations Environment Programme. 2022 marks 50 years since the first international meeting on the environment, and this year's theme is Only One Earth. Like there is only one Berg Estuary. This estuary has been declared a Ramsar site, which means that this valuable wetland receives national and international recognition as a site of ecological importance. It's a pity that Mbali isn't here. I should have known that she'd be out and about. I really need to talk to her about the Berg Estuary. Oh well, I'll pop back later.
Hello, Premier Windy.
Oh, hi, CapeNature Bot.
I couldn't help but hear you're looking for Mbali. Would you like me to dial her in live? She's actually at the Berg Estuary now.
Perfect. That'd be great. Thank you very much.
Hi, Premier Windy. It's great to see you. How are you?
I'm doing very well in Bali, and by the looks of it, so are you.
Yep, for sure. I'm definitely in my happy place here in the Berg Estuary.
Great to hear. I'm so glad I caught you. I'm really excited about World Environment Day, and especially the Berg Estuary. In Bali, why don't you tell us why estuaries are so important?
Good question. Estuaries are sensitive and dynamic ecosystems. The Berg Estuary is a coastal wetland, which means it has a mix of salt water from the ocean and fresh water coming inland from the mountains. The Berg Estuary is one of the largest estuaries in the country, spanning over 61 kilometers, and is made up of 5 different wetland types, which is super important to wildlife.
Doesn't the Berg Estuary also have the third largest salt marsh on the Cape Coast?
Indeed it does, Premier. And salt marshes help absorb large quantities of greenhouse gases from the atmosphere. Salt marshes actually store carbon dioxide, which decreases the effects of global warming. Pretty cool, hey? Pardon the pun. When fresh water mixes with salt water, it creates habitats for various fish and birds. Also, unique plants grow, such as waterblommiki, soutbos, and sariegras.
Hang on, did you say waterblommiki? My wife often makes waterblommiki bredi, and it's one of the family's favorites. So you mentioned it creates habitats for certain wildlife. Tell me more.
For sure. The Berg Estuary is also a top bird watching destination. Many birders come from all over the world to sit and watch some 127 different species. Some migratory birds even fly all the way from Europe to hang out here during the summertime. Did you know that the lesser flamingo feeds primarily on algae and invertebrates? And this food gives the birds their pink color.
That's really interesting, Mbali. One of the other reasons why the Berg Estuary is so important is that it's a popular recreational fishing spot. This helps promote the local economy and tourism. The benefits of the estuary are never ending.
I couldn't agree more. And this site is also really important for fish, such as the critically endangered ones, like the white steenbras and the white stump nose. During their young years, white steenbras prefer shallower waters like estuaries. They are on the SASSI red list of threatened species, so it is illegal to sell or buy them anywhere in South Africa.
And estuaries are extremely important for these and other fish to breed. They provide a sheltered, shallow habitat for fish and are important nursery areas for young fish. In fact, when it comes to biodiversity, the Berg is one of the most important estuaries in our country. Did you know we benefit from a number of goods and services from the estuary? Things such as tourism, salt production, and fishing, to name a few. They're worth over 380 million rand to the local economy per year. Interesting fact, bokkoms is the most iconic food of the area and an invaluable part of the cultural heritage in Velddrift. It also makes up the largest source of protein for the majority of families. We must do everything in our power to protect this estuary.
That's right. and 17 out of 35 fish species found in the area are partially or fully dependent on the estuaries to complete their life cycle. The importance of its conservation cannot be emphasized enough.
So, the question remains, how do we keep the Berg estuary functioning as it should?
Estuaries like the Berg need space to grow, and by this, we mean flooding. The reason for this is that plants depend on regular and consistent flooding, which shapes the banks and bottom of the estuary. Some plant species require more salty water to grow, like salt marshes. Others rely on steady flow of fresh water from upstream to flourish. So water flowing in from the river helps to keep the estuary healthy.
Do you remember a few years ago, the province experienced a severe drought? The estuary took a massive knock as it experienced little to no flooding. That's why it's so important for everyone to conserve water. You never know when another climate crisis could face us. It's better that we start to build good green habits now. How else can we help Mbali?
Well, we can make sure that we don't farm or build our houses too close to the water, or, to use a fancy word, the estuarine functional zone. This way, we allow the river to flood as needed.
Well, Mbali, the Western Cape government is also helping to monitor water that is flowing into the estuary. We are clearing invasive alien trees, grasses, and shrubs that live along the river as these suck up too much water. By planting indigenous vegetation in its place, the Berg River Improvement Plan has rehabilitated over 15 hectares of estuarine land. We are now seeing bird species return to the area that have been absent for over 30 years.
That is quite an achievement.
Indeed, Mbali. So everyone must keep up the good work, and we as government will continue to do our part.
Awesome. And for those watching, remember, we should always do our part. So, plant indigenous species, remove invasive species, save water, and reduce, reuse, and recycle.
Spot on, Mbali. Thank you for taking my call, and keep up the good work in the Berg.
Will do, Premier. See you soon.
Bye, Mbali. Sure, time flies when you're having fun. Gotta go. Thanks for joining us, and as Mbali would say, until next time, nature lovers, goodbye.